Hello, teachers and students and class. I think you may sit down. Right, teachers, we are still on the same strand. What is science in the home? Our sub-strand, learning about substance. We're still on the same outcome, 8.3.1. Conducting investigations and use collected data to identify patterns in the physical interactions of substances. Our topic for today will be how much is enough? How much sugar do we put in our coffee, in our tea? So how much do we think is enough for our tea? Can I have some hands, please? Okay.
2 spoons.
Some have 2 spoons. Jared, you?
1.5 teaspoon.
1.5 spoon, okay. Thank you for your answers. Some people like to drink 2, some people like to drink 1, some people like to drink 1.5. Everybody have their own taste. But do we know that how much we put into the cup of tea is enough for the liquid or too much? So before we go into our activity, we will find out that in our activity. But there are a few words that I would like us to have a look at. So let's have some volunteers to hold on to this. Thank you, Rose. Come, Ella. Boys. In front, stand in front, in line. The order of the paper that I give to you here. Just line up. Okay, one group at the back. Thank you. Let's start from our first. Move close. Move close. Closer, close, 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 close. Let's start from your right, which is solution. Oh, so that's your left. We'll start from your left. Thank you. The word is solution. The second word is?
Solution.
The third word?
Saturation.
Say the word saturation.
Saturation.
The fourth word?
Solute.
Solute. And the fifth and the final word?
Solvent.
Good. Here with me are the definitions of the 5 words. Now, I think you have touched some of these in your lesson. So we'll have another 5 students to match their partner. Any volunteers? The first one. Our next one. Come up. Here. Boys. The last one. Okay. We'll have the first one to read this. Find your partner. Read the first definition on our left. Read again. The second pair? The third pair? Read. The fourth pair? On the side. Very good. We're going to pass him. Read the fourth pair. Definition. And the last one. Is there any corrections? Read the last one again. Right, is there any changes that you need to make? Which definition do you think needs to move around to the correct word? Okay. No. Yes. Any correction? Right. When we do the experiment, you will find out those correct definitions: solution, suspension, saturation, solute, and solvent. So we'll have them pin it up on the board. Pin yours up on the board. Up. Under the definition. The two together. With all clear table, we should begin our activity now. Right, let's clear out our tables. Put our things on the aside. Books need to be cleared. Clear books away. Take a piece of paper and copy down this prediction table. The table is up. You have the name of the substance. The first column, prediction. The question there to help you answer, write down your prediction. Observation in the second column. The third column, explanation. leaders or your runners to come up to collect your materials. Right, you have copied down the table with, and ready for the activity. We should begin our activity now. So, first clear out your table. I still see things on the table. So clear out your table, let your tables be clean. Only a small notebook or a rough pad for you to jot down your notes. Right, your instruction number one. This is your instruction number one that you are going to follow. You have 30 seconds to do instruction number one. You have 30 seconds to do instruction number one. We shall move to our next instruction, instruction number two. Instruction number two will require you fetching water. So I would like you to be careful when you are fetching water. Make sure you do not spill any water. Take time one at a time. After one fetches, you should fetch yourself your group water. Okay, this is your next instruction. Instruction number three, if you haven't added that yet. Instruction number three. You got 100 meals already, 100 meal spoons. Then what, you're supposed to pour it in there. How many spoons did you pour? You blend the enemy instruction. Teaspoon. Okay, pour him out. Let's go to instruction number 4. Instruction number 5. Let's go to instruction number 4. Instruction number 5. Good. Are you timing?
Is it? Hold on, she's good.
Okay, so when you want to stop, push this side. Push it down. our next instruction. You will repeat the same steps for the other substance. Did you miss? Are those who have finished? Your questions, you have 5 questions. Those are the first 3 questions. You'll find your questions also in your Right, the other 2 questions. If you have got your students' workbook, teachers, students, you may look that in your look up that in your students' workbook. Okay, once you have finished all your filings, you compile your answers. Compile your answers, record what you have done, and put it in a table form. Present your information on a table, and we will look at it in our next lesson. So present information on a table. Each group is responsible. Group leaders, make sure that all the information that you have collected be presented in a table, which we will look at in our next lesson. Before we go, here is our summary, our first point for our summary. Summary point number 1. Different substances dissolve in water in different amounts. Summary point number 2. the amount of solute that can dissolve in water is known as the solubility of a substance. Anyone would like to read the next one?
Excuse.
Our third summary point. Substances dissolve at different rates depending on the physical property they have. Next summary point. When a substance is dissolved into the liquid, we say a solution is formed. All right. Before I finish today's lesson, I would like to ask you a question. Why did we mix all those substances? What did we really want to find out? Why did we pour a spoon of salt into 100 mils of water, a spoon of sugar, flour? Why did we do that? What did we actually want to know? Fine. Anyone? Yes. Thank you. Winnie? To
find their solubility.
To find
their solubility.
Any other answers? Thank you for your answer. Very good answer. We'll have the last one.
To find the different rates of its substances.
To find the different rates, the solubility, to find its solubility, to find the different rates. We'll have the last one, a boy, this time.
To find if it is a soluble or insoluble substance.
Okay, to find whether it is soluble or insoluble substance. Right, all those three answers that you gave are correct. You found it yourself, whether it is soluble, and or insoluble, or how long does it take to dissolve. So that will bring us to our key phrase. Anyone would like to guess what is our key phrase?
How much is enough?
Right, how much is enough? Our key phrase, how much is enough? Thank you, good try. Our key phrase for today is solubility. And that will be our key phrase for today. Our next lesson will be teachers and students. Is volume. The shape makes it hard. These are the things that you will need to provide for your next lesson. Measuring cylinder, beakers, plastic bottles or glass bottles or glass jars. You will also need a teaspoon, pebbles or small stones, and a bucket of water. So again, those are the things that you will need to bring. So teachers, do take note of those things for your next lesson. And with that, thank you teachers and students, and class.